Welcome to Uliza, a ministry of kuzaapp.com, where you can ask questions and we will give you a biblical response. Now let's hear today's question.
Is Christianity a white man's religion? Recently we've had a number of conversations going on in regard to Christianity, and there are many people that are opposed to Christianity, claiming that it is about a white person, it's from the white people. They are using it to colonize and to come and hold captive the minds of the Africans, and so that we have many Africans that are becoming more and more resentful towards the gospel. We've had a bishop recently who happens to recant Christianity, going back to Africa tradition religion, and again on the same basis, claiming that Christianity is a white man thing. And we have so many young people also that are struggling with this subject, and a part of it is because of our ignorance on the part of history of Christianity, even history of the Bible itself, whereby the Bible has enough facts that it presents to us concerning its origin, concerning the African person. We can confidently say, for example, that the history of salvation, it's about talk of the children of Abraham in African soil, that is of course in Egypt, talk of Moses having been in Egypt, talk of Jesus, talk of so many people in the scriptures, including two of the major tribes of Israel that have their roots from Africa. We talk about Ephraim and Manasseh, who are actually children of Joseph, and Joseph happened to marry an African. And so we have so many individuals in the scriptures that we can confidently say that they were from Africa. And so the story of Christianity being a white man's religion and spreading all over, making so many Africans to resent the gospel, refuse salvation, it is unfounded. It has no both biblical and historical foundation, and so that the rumors has just been spread all around. We have in our TV station, one time I was listening to a Kikuyu station, and we heard these presenters speaking of the Bible also as a white man's book, and you know, speaking of how it was used to colonize the Africans. But colonialism is very recent compared to the history of Christianity. And so that at this point, we'd like just to present some of this background of Africans in the Bible. And this one will help to create more confidence amongst the Africans. It will also help to put the facts right when we talk about African and Christian history. And this is very important. In the scriptures, as I mentioned earlier, we talk of people like Ephraim and Manasseh that had an African mother. And when also we have the Israelites coming out of Egypt, the Bible, read Exodus 12:38, you'll see that it was a mixed race of Africans and the Israelites. And so that we cannot entirely say that Christianity as we have it, it is even from the white society. Looking at the Israelites themselves, they were not white. Looking at the what they were comprised of in terms of coming from Egypt, they were comprised of Africans and mostly again Israelites. So we can confidently say that the Christian history has a big foundation and has a big base when we talk about Africans being involved in the salvation history. We have people like even one of the prophetic books, Prophet Zephaniah. He happened to be an African, and the mother was a Jew and the father was an African. And so that for him to be accepted as part of God's people, Deuteronomy 23:7-8 had given instructions that if such a person was to be accepted in the Jewish race, he had to trace back through fourth generations for him to be accepted as a Jewish person. And so we have Zephaniah, who happens to be an African, having an African father, and it's a prophetic book in the Bible that we are proud of to say it was written by an African, of course, to the world. And so that becomes very encouraging. Zephaniah had to trace his generation fourth generation backwards, and it all goes back to King Hezekiah. And so it gives the African mind more confidence about their historicity when it comes to the scriptures. Think about Jesus Christ, of course, and the parents of taking refuge in Africa, so that Africa interacted with Christ at a personal level. Think of somebody like Simon of Cyrene, who happened to cross, to carry the cross of Christ Jesus. He happened to be from Africa, from Libya. And so that again tells us that Africans had great contact with Christ and with the Bible, even before we think of the Christianity going to Europe or any other part of the Western world. And so the African person, we need to be aware of this part of history, that what we've been hearing, rumors, hearsay, and people have taken that as facts. We refuse to go back to the Bible. We refuse to go back to history to be able to find the roots of Christianity in our African soil. And so it is important that rather than just operating from hearsay, from what people are thinking and those who are outside there to damage the gospel, it's important for us to get our facts right. Now, besides these individuals that we have mentioned, which gives an evidence of the black people being part of Christianity even before colonialism, we have so many other parts of the Bible still that gets to give us the proof of Christians and or Christianity, the Bible itself being part of the African history. Think of the first gospel to be written. For example, that's the Gospel of Mark. And we have Matthew and Luke copying, of course, from Mark, which again it is can be well explained from history. The first gospel, that is the book of Mark, is written by John Mark, who happened to be born in African soil. That is again in Libya. And so that gives the African person more confidence that this gospel we are talking about, we have many Africans that have contributed to it, including somebody like John Mark and the author of the first gospel. Think of somebody like Apollos, for example, also in 1 Corinthians. This gentleman was born in Alexandria. And so, again, it gives us more confidence about the African person being well involved in the writing, in the teaching of God's word. And so we need to demystify the myths, the stories that are outside there. And this is where we are coming out strongly to present this information to the African young person and even to the pastors and to the adults, so that they are aware that they are aware of our history. I have been teaching some of the Bible schools and with materials, of course, written from the West. And one of the disservices that I've realized has been done is when our story is not told in most of this Bible training school, so that many pastors, even in Africa, they are not aware of these facts. I shared with a number of 70 pastors in a classroom that I happened to be training, and most of them were shocked that you mean that we have contributed this much in Christianity. They were really shocked because they did not anticipate. Even to them, they thought that it was a white man's religion. And so it is important for us to have these facts right. Think about the day of Pentecost also in Acts chapter 2. We have the Africans being part of that. They were in Jerusalem and during the day of Pentecost. And so among the 3,000 that converted after that experience of the tongues of fire, What we have is that we have Africans being part of this congregation of the people. And this is way before even colonialism. Think about the Ethiopian eunuch. Again, this is another individual way before even colonialism. And so that if we want to think of Christianity as a white man's religion, then we are misled, because it has no facts. It has no both biblical and even historical backing about that. John Mark himself, the writer of the first gospel, happened even to die in Africa, was preaching in the synagogues in Egypt, and that's where he happened to die. And so I want to stamp the authority more based on God's word. Those scriptures, you can read them. You know, those stories are facts. They are there in the Bible, and they can affirm us more and assure an African person that this is not a white man's religion. And so I would like us to rethink again, because in the process of fighting the white person, we end up missing the bigger point of salvation. And so why do you have to miss heaven on the ground that this was a white man thing? And whatever basis of your arguments are, they are not even founded, whether in history or even in the Bible. And so you cannot reject the gospel on hearsay. You have to get your facts right. And we'd like to welcome you to join with us. Let us believe in this God. Let us know that Christianity, it's not about whether it's about a white man or a black man. We talk about Christ Jesus. We talk about him being the savior of the entire world. And so let us get our facts right, and let us defend the gospel, because it is surely the power, you know, of God for the salvation of everyone that believes. Thank you so much, and God bless you.
Thank you for watching Uliza. Please check out more of our digital resources at kuzaapp.com. If you have a question that you would like a biblical response to, please send in your question to us at kuzaapp@gmail.com. Text us on 0799-254-254 or send us a message on our Facebook at Kuza App.